Okay, so I have just named it after keying that. I have just named this layer. Now, what you have to do is you have to add some kind of light wrap. Okay, so to add a light wrap to this, what you have to do is you have to duplicate this layer. So you have to just duplicate this layer, Control D. Okay. So now what you have to do is you have to bring this, whatever is the background is there. What I have to do is I have to bring on the type of character so that the lighting in the background blends with this character. So what I'll do, you can see now. Okay, so now what I'll do is I'll just have duplicated the layers. So I have to duplicate this footage layer. Now go to effect and then go to color correction and add a tint to it. I just want to make like a mask for this layer. So I'll just add this tint and this black also. I have to make it white. Okay, so like this one layer, I have to make it like this. Okay. So you name it as white, white mask. And again, I'll just duplicate the same layer, white mask, Control D. Okay, so for this white mask, you name it as black. Okay, so and this tint, what we have to do is you have to turn this tint both into black layer. So we have two layers, one is white and one is black. And for this black layer, you go to effect and matte and simple choker you do and reduce this, increase this choker. So you can see like this outline. Okay. So I just created one black layer, one white layer. So for the black layer, I just adjusted the simple matte choker. So what it will do is it will compress that. And you can see only the white outline over here. Now you pre-compose this two layers. You have to select both the layers. Then pre-compose that layers. Okay, so you have to press Control Shift and C. And pre-compose it into a one layer. So I'll just name it as light wrap. Light wrap mask. So I have to name that as a layer as a light wrap mask for this. So if I just press OK. Okay, so that is like a single layer over here. So now we can see that it becomes a single layer. And we can see this outline. Now what you can do is you have to select the background layer. Select this background layer, duplicate it one more time. So Control D, duplicate it. Move above the footage layer. And inside this track pit, you have to give Luma Mat. So what happens over here, if I switch off, you can see that there is some kind of outline. We are seeing it over here. So the background is coming inside this outline. Okay, so the background comes into this outline. Now what you can do is you can select this layer mask. And I can just go to right click adjustment layer. Go to effect blur. And I'll just add some Gaussian blur to it. So, like, what happens over here inside this our video? We can see that we can see the background through this outline. We can see it. Now, if I switch on this, now there will be some kind of light which will be affecting to this footage. So, if I switch off this BG, you can see that some light is affecting this footage now. So, whatever is in the background, that light is coming on the top of it. So if you reduce the blur amount, so if you don't want this much blur, I'll just reduce the blur amount little. So how much blur it has to be added, you can add it over there. So if you want less, totally less over here. So light wrap, we add it to give some kind of blending between this layer. Okay, so if it is like this, you can see that now there is a problem over here. So what you can do is you can increase the blurness inside that. So select this layer, light wrap, add amount of blur. So how much you want to blend that light inside this? Come to keying, and that light will blend over here. If you switch off and switch on, you can see that light is coming on the top of it. If you have some kind of light in the background that you want to bring it on the top of it, you can bring that. Okay, so you can use this light wrap to add on the top of it, on the edges. If you want to add this, this light wrap will help you to add some kind of background on the top of it. So whenever you're keying, make sure that light wrap, you have to add it to the scene. Okay, so once we have done this, now I think it is too much. So if you want to reduce the amount of it, reduce the opacity of this. Okay, so now we have to do the color correction for this. So when you are doing the color correction, okay, so select the green screen footage. So I'm not doing the color correction for the background. I have to select the green screen footage. Yeah.
So why are we reducing the opacity of the layer, sir?
No, it was too much. The light was too much affecting in the background. So I reduced that. See, it is affecting the face also.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so I have to just reduce it little bit. I just want little edges to blend. So you can see that it should not be too much, because here the background is little black. So if there is some kind of amount of light is there, the light wrap will be good to see, the edges will be lighting more. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So I'll just now reduce the opacity of that. I select the footage, green screen footage, go to effect, color correction. And same like Photoshop. Okay, so inside the color correction, we have a lot of tools. We have curves, we have levels, and we have a lot of tools over here. So we will be just working on curves and levels. Okay, so let's go for this curve tool, because you have been using this curve tool inside Photoshop. So let's go for curve. Okay, so first thing, when you do the color correction for any of the footage, is to adjust the brightness and contrast of this photo. Okay, so this has to match with the background brightness and contrast of the background. So you select this curve. So inside this curve, left side top is called highlight. This control is for adjusting the shadow, and this is for adjusting the midtones of the image. Okay, or gamma or anything of this image. So if you want to adjust the contrast of this, you can just click on this and bring it down. So I'm just making dark more darker, bright more brighter by bringing this down. Okay. So if you want to make this brightness little bit of less, so if you want to reduce if the brightness, if you want to reduce, go to the top of the curve. And then you bring it down. So it will remove the highlight from the photo. So if I bring this down, you can see that highlight region, it is getting reduced. Okay, so this is to adjust the highlight of the image. This is for the midtones. And this part is to adjust the shadow of the image. Suppose if I want to increase or decrease the shadow, you can see that shadow region only will get affected when I adjust it over here. Okay, so I just want to adjust till here. Okay, so now we have to see that what is there inside the shadow over here. Now we have to adjust individual channels over here. So you go to red channel. Okay, so when I go to the red channel, we can see this red line inside this curve. And here also I can go for this red channel over here. So if I click, you can go for the red channel to check, to do the correction inside red. Okay. So now you can see the highlight, how much red is there, how much amount is there, red is inside the shadow. If you feel the shadow is too dark or too bright, you can adjust the shadow over here. So go to this red channel, only this shadow. So whether you want to increase this red, if I move up, it is going to add the red. If I move towards right, it is going to remove the red amount of red inside the shadow. So this part, you will be adjusting the midtones. And top part, you will be adjusting the highlight. So amount of red you want to reduce from the photo, you can reduce, or if you want to add, you can add it. So I am seeing through individual channel. Now go to green channel. Now here also you have to change to green. Okay, so amount of shadow color, if you feel the shadow is too dark, or amount of green has to be reduced or increased, you can adjust it. So here now I'll just adjust the green amount here inside the midtones. Now go for blue channel. Again, I go for blue channel over here. Now you can see that blue, how it matches with this background. So if you want to add little more blue or reduce the amount of blue, let's reduce little bit. Now go to RGB, and here also RGB. So we added some changes to that. So if I just switch off and switch on, you can see that we have done some color correction to it. Okay, so this was before, and after adjusting the curve, we have just adjusted like this to adjust with the background now. Okay, so now our next job is to add some kind of grade. Okay, so we have done the color correction now. So now what we'll do is we'll add some kind of color grade to this. To do some kind of color grading, okay, so you have to select this, right click, new, adjustment layer. Okay, it's same like Photoshop. We add a new adjustment layer. Then I go to effect. Here also we have come color correction. And here we have something called Lumetri color option over here. So you can also use inside color correction, you can also go for curves, or I can use this Lumetri color. So if I click on this Lumetri color, and here we have a lot of color correction tools. So if I go for color correction tool, go to creative option. And this is where I want to change the grade of this. I can use this grade. So we have option over here, creative. This top things I have already done. So top thing, you have something called temperature. So if you want to adjust the temperature of this footage, you can adjust warm temperature or cool temperature you want. So if you want little warmer or cool, more bluish tone you want, you can just adjust it here itself. Okay, so you can adjust it the temperature over here, and here also we have this option for doing the creative. So shadow, what color you want, and highlight, what color we want over here, we can adjust. Suppose shadow you want a little bit of blue, so I can increase blue inside the shadow region, and highlight you want orange, so you can just move this towards orangeish tone. Okay, so I done the grading now a little bit. So we have this orange and bluish tone to this picture. So if I just switch off and switch on and show you this. See, this was original. Okay, so this was original when I add this Lumetri color, and this is what we got after doing the color correction. Okay, so very light tone. We are just changing that tone to this. So now what we can do is now we have to add the elements into this. So some of the elements we'll be adding to this photo. So now it is too much static. Now to add some kind of elements, so I'll just go to this. I have this some of this elements over here. So I'll just drag and drop this element. So if you are done inside this motion graphics, so HUD display, you can create like this elements. This is the video. Okay, so if you have the element which is like this, and which is this color is like this, so make sure that it is below that layer. Now change the mode to screen. Whenever you have that elements in black screen, you can go to this layer blending mode and change that into a screen mode. So as soon as I change that into screen mode, you can see that how the screen is going to come over here. Now we need to animate this. What I'll do is I'll just make the layer as a 3D layer. Okay, so 2.5D, what you can use it. So just come down, toggle switches and mode. You can select this and turn that layer into 3D. Okay, so once I turn that into 3D, what you can do is you can press R and rotate it. Okay, so we can see that in a 3D mode. And you have to make sure that it matches our eye contact. So I'll just place it above here. Just place it here. So we have this x-axis, adjust that. And this is the z-axis if I want little far. Okay, so some kind of screen I just want to add on the top of it. So what will happen is that screen will come over there. Okay, so little bit more. So just adjust this position of this little part, z axis here and this little here. So just align the position of this layer. Now what we can do is we can just animate it. So in the starting it should not be there. So as she looks up, so I need to animate the scale. So scale, you give the key, starting it should be 0. And here after 10 or 25 frames, I'll just make it 100. So we have this screen now. So if I just play that. Same time. Okay, so when if it is taking time over here, I'll just make it into quarter size and then check it. Just this is just for testing. So it will scale and it will have that animation. So it is having some kind of like this. So if you want to remove that, you can remove it, or if you feel that that is fine, you can just keep it. To remove that, you can select this layer, go to effect, color correction and levels. And you can adjust this levels. Okay, so when I adjust the levels, it is going to remove that border kind of thing from this picture. Okay, so it will come like this. So it is little bit still, it is there. If you want to totally remove, you can remove, but keep little bit there, otherwise it won't look nice. So we have this now. Now what we want to do is I want this screen to be a little bit of more blue in color. So select this layer, go to effect, color correction, tint, and I will change this color to more of this color. So we can see that now we have this screen. Now we can go to effect again, go to color, stylize this time, and we'll add some kind of glow to this. So you can reduce the threshold. Now you can see that we can add some kind of glow for this. So how much amount you want for this glow radius, how much amount you want. So little glow radius I'll give. This much is fine. Okay, so we have some of the screen which is coming over here like this. So it is scaling from down, then it rises. Okay, so I can also add one more screen over here. So I'll just have, so we have this stock footage. I'll just bring one more video. So this is one more video like this. Okay, so for this also what I'll do is I'll just change this into 3D view. Okay, so if you want to copy the same position of this, you can press P, copy this position, select this layer, press P, and you can paste it, Control V. Okay, so for rotation also press R, see whatever the rotation value, Control C, and for this R, I can select the rotation value of this. So this is Y. Okay, so now you can change this mode to again screen. So go to toggle switches, again you go for screen mode. Okay, so it will be at exactly at the same place over here. Okay, so for this also what we'll do is we'll just give this tint. So go to effect, color correction, tint, and I just want to choose the same color over here. Okay, so we have. Now for this also I'll just give the scale animation. So starting it should not be there, so scale it, so it should be zero. And after some time here I just want to make it 100. Okay, so this is how it will happen. And after some time, I want this layer to come out. So you can just give the position key also for it. So it comes out from this here like this. So you can see that how it is going to come out over here. And for this layer also, you can add a glow to it. Okay, so go to effect, go to stylize, and you can add a glow. Reduce the threshold amount. Intensity, I just increase. Okay, so we have this layer now. Okay, so you can see now. So what we have done is we have just made the layer into 3D and just animated the scale, and I just animated the position of it. It comes out like this. Okay, so this is what will happen. But when this is happening, what you have to do is you have to also make sure that the light comes on our face also. Now her face is looking, it is not blending with this background which is happening. So what you have to do is you have to add one more layer. So when this is coming out, the light has to come on her face also. So whatever this blue light is there, that should be affecting on her face. So what we have to do is we have to create that mask also on her face and do some color correction for that also. So if I just see this now. Okay, so any of these things we can do. I also want some kind of line scan on our face. So I'll be doing that also over here. So first we will do one by one all these things. So first we have done this layer. Now what you have to do is you have to add here some color. The same color has to affect on her. So what I have to do is I have to just create one more solid layer. Okay, so just create a solid layer, right click, solid. Just create one solid layer, and that I want to pick the color from the same light, because that is the lighting which will affect our face. So pick a little bit of darker. Okay, so once I have done that lighting, okay, so what we have to do is I'll just switch off this layer, and on this solid layer, what I'll do is I'll just draw a mask on our face. So using a pen tool, just draw some mask on our face. So I just draw till here only. After that, I'll adjust one more mask on the body also. Now switch on this layer. So it will be like this. Okay, so what I have to do is I have to change this blending mode now. So you can change this blending mode. So go here. You can change this to any of this. You can change for soft light. Okay, or add. Okay, so you can change it to whatever the thing you want. So you can just change to soft light. Now press F on the keyboard, feather, and increase the amount of feather on our face. So by default, we have this mask which is too sharp. Now to make this mask little bit of softer, you have to increase this mask feather. So you have to open the mask option. Inside that you have this mask feather. Now increase this amount of that, and we can see some light will affect on our face. So if I switch off and switch on, okay, so that light also should affect on our face when you are doing this thing, and on her body also. See, that also has to affect on her body also. So you don't have to do create another layer like that. I'll just select this same mask and layer, and I'll just add on her body also. So I'll just add on her hand and ear also. So just start adding this light. So it will be like this. Okay. So it is too much bright. So press F on the keyboard, and for the second mask also you have to adjust the feather. So little bit of bluish tone which will come on the body and hand also. So that's what I want to do. So some amount of light will be there on her. So what will happen from the starting, it won't be there. So when that comes, only I have to animate the opacity of this layer. Now we have this lighting from the starting itself. So I'll just give the opacity 0. Okay, so when that starts coming over here like this, at this frame, I'll just animate the opacity of this to 100. Okay, so when that thing comes, only the light will affect our face. So you can see this now. Okay, so some amount of glow should be there on our character also. So we have this now. If I just play that. Okay. Now I can see this, how it works. Okay, so if I want to adjust little bit of position of this, press P. So you can just move it more far. So it exactly in that position. So I'll just adjust here, that's fine. Okay, so now what I want to do is I want some kind of scanning on our face. Okay, so some kind of line will scan her face when this comes on the top. So it will happen like this. It comes out, and I want some kind of line which will scan her face. So for that, what you can do is you can create right click new. I can create a shape layer. So click on this shape layer. Now you just go to pen tool and just draw one shape over here. So from this point, I'll just draw one shape. So till here, and give this stroke for that shape layer. So I just want to pick the same color stroke. So you can go and pick the same color stroke over here. So it's fine. This color is okay. Okay, so now this I need to animate from top till here. Okay, so I can animate that layer. So this is the shape layer. Again, for the shape layer, you can just select the shape layer, adjust the position of this. So open the shape layer, you can open the contents, open the path. So I just want to animate the path for this layer. So select this path, give a key. And what will happen for this path is in the starting, it will be like this. So after some time, after some time, I just want this part to come down, not the shape. So I'll just select all these points, bring it down over here. And you can also adjust this path shape also. So if I just want to adjust the shape like this. And we don't want any of the fill in this layer. So I just want only the stroke to be animated like that. So here it will come. And here I just want to adjust the path little bit. So here. So if you want to do like this, I just want to adjust the path properly. So it goes over here. Goes over here also. Okay, so we have this now, something which is coming on our face like scanner. Now for this, on the top first frame, let me add the shape of this. I'll just change it little up. So I just want like this. So let it scan like this. So we have something like a 3D kind of scanner over there. Now now here, what is the problem over here is the stroke is too sharp over here. To make it rounded, you have to go to the stroke and you have to go to this line cap option, change it to rounded cap. So it becomes rounded over here. Now let's add some kind of glow to this. So go to effect, stylize, and we can add a glow. So amount of glow, I can just change this to this same color, reduce the threshold for this glow. Glow radius little bit, radius I'll increase for this glow and reduce the threshold for. Okay, so the glow color also, I just want to change to this color, blue. Okay, so now in the blending mode, now it is in a normal, I can change to add, or you can go for soft light here. So when I give the soft light, I have to just duplicate the layer. So we have some kind of scan which is going on her face. Okay, so let's duplicate this layer. So what, and the starting it should not be there. So what I'll do is here, I want to animate the opacity of this layer also. Press T, here it should be 0. Then after some times it comes 100. Then when it comes down over here, here also I have to make animate that from here to 0. So 2 times. So once it comes and then it scans and then it becomes 0 again. So you can duplicate the layer, Control D. So you can see the amount of light there. So for this layer, let's give add. So now we can see that out. Okay, so now you give little bit of blur also for this. So it should not be too sharp. So go to blur. Just give Gaussian blur. I don't want that much sharp for this. Even for this layer, go to effect, go to blur, give some blur for that. Otherwise it will be too sharp. Just like this. I just want some something to pass on our skin. So it will come. Okay, so if you want to increase the timing of this, press U. And you can always adjust the timing of this layer. So you can select all the keys, hold Alt on the keyboard, left click and drag. So I want this to happen for some longer time. Now I can see the card. What will happen is it it will also have that effect on the skin and the light scanning is happening on our face. Blends. Okay.